Get ready to match the stars from the Love Boat, Bernie Kabel, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly. From Entertainment Tonight, Audrey Woods, Scully Mitchell, and from Harper Valley GTA, Edie McClure, as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game. And now, here's the star of Match Game, Gene Reber.
Hello, John. How are you? Good bunch out there? Good. Hey. Hey. Oh, boy. Well, you're going to love it because you got a good bunch up here.
Yeah.
Yes, I'm glad you put on a jacket to make me feel at home.
Gene, I feel so much more dignified now that we are theatrical people and I understand about your theatrical experiences out in the world. I had to put on a jacket just for that.
Thank you very much. Bernie and I were talking about the theater. I just came back from Dallas a short while ago, did a play called Tribute, and he and
By
I are
Bern
both...
By Slade, the playwrights like to be mentioned.
Bernard Slade.
And I hear...
Who wrote a wonderful play, incidentally.
And it's not appropriate to say this about yourself, but I understand that Gene Reber got amazingly good reviews.
This is going to be a long conversation.
Considering
what happened to us?
I got fantastic reviews. That's what I got. Yeah. Thank you, Dallas. I love you.
Hey.
All right. Thank you, Bernie. I love you, too.
Very least I could have done.
Yes.
Hello.
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 Darling.
Are you going to be rotten again? What are you doing there? You can't plug that. No plugging on this show.
Oh, no. Oh. No, no.
Gene.
Gene.
They always said this about Gene. They always said this about him.
Take it off. Go away.
Well, listen, bet he gets a lot of big jobs now?
Some guy's going to tune in the middle of the show and look at him and say, what the heck? Well, I know California, they dress casual, but this is ridiculous.
Well, Gene, I've always depended upon the kindness of strangers.
Listen, let's say hello to Carol Wainert and Charlie Brown over here. Sorry.
Oh, dear.
Oh, listen. Hold on. Just a second. Just take a second. Don't worry about it.
That's what the bishop said to the actress.
And when he finishes, it's going to look just like... going to look just like one of his three-piece suits. You'll never...
Okay, darling.
Is that it? How's that feel? All right?
Right here.
Good. Okay. Now, how do you do? What would you like to do? Carol, you know... Oh, you're going to write your answers anyway. Just hold them up. Carol here is a petty officer in the Navy. She's been in for 5 years. She's stationed in the South Pole. How many ladies are there down there?
We hit an all-time high this last season of 11 women.
11 women?
Right.
Gets lonely, doesn't it?
No, there's in excess of 600 men.
Oh, can't get lonely. Oh, wonderful. Charlie Brown here is a saloon keeper from San Francisco. He's a nifty kid, a peachy dancer, and a snappy dresser. And we played one game. We're going to start with round two. The score is tied. Carol went first last time, so Charlie, you go first this time.
A, please.
A, it is. Love talking to you, Charlie. Okay.
You too, Charlie.
Yes. Francine said... My blind date said he looked like Cary Grant. I just saw him in person. He looks more like blank Grant. All right. Okay. Francine said, my blind date said he looked like Cary Grant. I just saw him in person, and he looks more like blank Grant.
General Grant.
General Grant. Right. All right, Bernie Baby.
Okay, I thought he looked a little more like Ulysses S. Grant.
That was General Grant.
General Grant.
Right, indeed. Very good. Ulysses, U.S. Grant.
After our last encounter, Charlie,
I didn't want to have anything bad happen, so I used it all. Your General, your Ulysses, your...
You got it all.
You
okay.
All bases. Here's the Charlie.
Lou Grant.
Lou Grant. I find him rather attractive.
You've always been bizarre in your taste.
That's
sexually
true.
Speaking.
Said he looked like Cary Grant. I just saw him personally. Looks more like Blank Grant.
The General.
Ulysses. All right. Great for him. What'd you say, Tattersall?
I didn't comprehend, you know. I say he looks more like a government grant.
A government grant. That would be poverty stricken. You've got the rags to show it, haven't you?
Yeah.
There's a little in Congress there. He's got more gold on his body than 12 of us have in our teeth.
But see, they're really going to enjoy it just before this show is over when I tear your suit up.
Aha! Aha! No, these Palm Beach suits can't be torn up.
Oh,
no, they glue them together. What have you got there for us, Edie?
Well, who's buried in Grant's tomb?
Who is buried in Grant's tomb? Now, wait a minute.
Cary Grant.
Cary Grant, right?
Ulysses S.
All right. Four for him. Now, Carol, you need 4 to tie and 5 to win. The sailor said, our captain needs... Hey!
Hey!
Hey, Carol.
How ironic.
The sailor said, this is a regular question. The sailor said our captain needs glasses. Instead of a signal flag, he just hung his blank on the mast.
Oh, darling, I'm going to have to read that.
Right. Sailor said our captain needs glasses. Instead of a signal flag, he just hung his blank on the mast. Oh, hold everything.
Wait.
What are you doing, Scoey?
I was writing my answer.
Oh.
It's a novel. He's writing a letter home.
Now we're ready for it. Just hung his blank on the mast.
His skivvies.
Skivvies.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
That's Navy talk for underwear. I gotta ask you something, Carol. They refer to the men's underwear as skivvies. What do they call the women's?
Skivets.
Skivets. When you're hot, you're hot. What do you say there?
Okay, I will take this to any, I'll take this to any court.
You're going to the Supreme Court.
Yes, I'll take this to any court in town. I was in the Navy. And skivvies are the same as shorts. Same.
Right. Good.
Okay. I'm not kidding.
Well, you got it.
And you can take that to the bank.
All right.
Boy, if you give him that, I want straw. That was from days
That's
ago.
That's from days ago. These people didn't even...
They don't care. They don't care.
They're laughing anything. What do they know?
They're thinking I've been with you 3 weeks.
All right, Ms. Brett, go.
Ms. Brett what?
Ms. Brett, show us your card and say it at the same time.
All right, darling. Oh, that's hard to do. You can't show your card and say it, can you? Well, let's try. Jockey shorts.
Jockey shorts. There's another one. What are you doing, Chuck?
I'm looking at the first and only word in the history of the world that has 2 V's in together.
Well.
There's not another word in the world.
Is that true, Carol?
I can't see that.
What, skivvies spelled with 2 V's or 1? S-K-I-V-V-I-E-S?
I think it's the wearer's choice.
The wearer's choice? Yeah, it is. What do you say?
Skivvies has 2 V's?
Maybe. Roger is the worst speller in the world, so you can't... Don't trust
nothing
him.
Nothing has 2 V's.
No, I don't think so.
What?
Shh. Fliver has 2 V's, right?
Fliver has 2 V's?
Fliver, F-L-I, means
fliver.
It.
Fliver.
I'll have it with bacon and dry, sure.
All right. Fliver has 2 V's. What do you say? Instead of a signal flag, you just hung a skivvies on the mast.
Where I come from, they call them
liver.
Drawers.
Draw! 4-4 is 4. One more and we win the game.
Can I hear the question?
Yeah. Yes.
Can I hear the question?
Our captain needs glasses. Instead of a signal flag, he just hung his skivvies on the mast.
His T-shirt that was torn by Gene Rayburn 1 week on the match game.
I see. All right.
Thought I'd get a bigger laugh than that.
Should I tear it again?
No, that's right.
What do you got for us, Edie?
Well,
is it a tie or a win?
Are we on tenterhooks here?
Yes, we are.
Well, get off your tenterhooks and put on your underdrawers.
Underdrawers.
set. Now we're gonna leave you off. We'll give you back later for game number two, okay? No. Oh no, he's going with $500. Say goodbye to Charlie Brown. Here's your message for you.
I sent him to what, the South Pole.
What duties do some of these other fellas here perform? I guess they're known to you personally, are they? Are they chief petty officers? What other ranks are there? Boot what?
No, they're all air traffic controllers, except for one weather guesser who's in the middle.
A weather guesser in the
and
middle.
And my sister who's on the end who's spending the summer with me from New Jersey.
That one, that cute one there with the blue... Yeah.
Halter top, it's right. called. Halter top.
Halter top, uh-huh. right. That's your sister, huh?
Right.
And the others are air traffic controllers and a meteorologist.
And a meteorologist.
And a meteorologist. Say something in adiabatic lapse rate. Well, all right, here we go for the big money. They're all rooting for you. We polled the studio audience and said, write down your best answer to this. It won't blank much. Now, three of the six stars will assist. Whom do you want?
I'll take Edie because she's winking at me over here.
All right.
It won't hurt much.
All right.
Bernie?
It won't squeak much.
Squeak much?
Squeak much.
That's rotten, Bernie. Boy, when you lay an egg, you lay an egg,
oh,
don't you?
That's yeah. Right. I go.
One more.
Brett.
Well, it's what I always used to say to Gene in Encino. It won't do much.
Another rotten one.
It won't
a rotten much. One. All right, hurt, do, or squeak are the three they've given you. What do you want, one of those or one of your own?
I'm going to take hurt.
You can take hurt?
That's it. Trust me, darling. That's your answer.
Wait a minute. You're into pain, are you?
Sure. A little pain and pleasure never hurt anybody.
See this whip, honey?
She's got her black on.
Right. Oh, I bet she's wearing a black garter belt under all that. All right, let's take a look at the $100 response. It won't cost much. Isn't that a good one? No one thought of that. That's a nifty one. The next one says... It won't matter much. That's another right. terrible one.
Oh, that was what I meant.
All right. Let's take a look at the $500 response.
I'm hurt. Yeah.
Oh. All right, Carol. And hut. You call that attention? Holy mackerel. Pay it. Hut.
Well, Gene, I
guess I lost it. I used to have it.
That's a great tune.
Carol, you got $500. You play for $5,000 or $10,000, depending on how the wheel spins. It's all up to you. There's a peg right up there. Grab it and give it a go. Here we go. All right. Are you ready to have a go at it?
Sure.
It won't hurt much. It
won't. Good luck anyway. Blank unit. UNIT. Blank unit. Blank unit. Blank unit. All right, your job is to match Coy. If you do that, you get $5,000. How do you match that?
Intensive care.
Intensive care unit. Oh, isn't that a good answer? Sounds good to me. Did you think of anything else? That was a hard one. I couldn't think of that one. I think that's kind of a good one. Have you got a good one too, Coy?
I guess. I don't have that one. Can't you think of something else?
No.
Come on, baby. I'm giving you a chance. You can get... $2,500, anyhow, yeah. God, that was a good answer. I didn't.
What'd
well,
you say?
Show it.
Huh?
Show
you
got
to show it.
I said air conditioning unit.
Air conditioning unit. All right, that's another good one.
I couldn't well, think of anything, really.
I'm glad you won some money. It'll help you keep warm down there in the South Pole.
Definitely.
Pleasure to meet you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. $500 for Carol Wainer. Bye.
Kathy Romero and Sharon Cox. Welcome, ladies. Let's get acquainted. Sharon, please tell us about you.
Okay, I am a native Californian. I am married, have one little boy that's 15 months old. I previously worked for 8 years as medical assistant, and I am now a housewife.
Okay, rule her out. Go to the next one. All right, good luck to Sharon. Kathy, let's hear about you.
I'm also a native Californian. I'm a recent college graduate with a degree in English. Right now, I'm just having fun till I go back to school to get my teaching credential. Mm.
I'll take
you
that
made,
one.
You were an English major, huh?
Yes.
I'll take that
one. Is Skivvy spelled with one V or two?
I think it's with one.
With one V?
Uh-huh. But don't quote me. Oh,
all right. All right. Two Vs? You sure, Ira? You looked it up. Ah, you cheated there. Two V's for Skivvies. All right, ladies, we'll start this game right after we do this for you. Here we go, ladies. Sharon, A or B?
I'll have B.
Are you ready?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
The princess said to the prince, she said, you had a better blank when you were a frog.
You had a better blank?
Waiting for you, Chuck. Gonna start without you. The princess said to the prince, you had a better blank when you were a frog.
Body?
Body is what she said. Now, wait a minute. What is wrong with body? One person stand up and tell me what is wrong with body. Say, no guts. Nobody out there wants to stand up and be counted. They give me those ohs, and then nobody wants it. What do you say?
I see that Sharon is a physical culture fiend as I am, and I agree. Body.
All right. One for her. Hey, you're screaming and howling. A minute ago, you were saying, oh.
Yeah.
You are a fickle bunch.
There were lots of choices in this question.
Yeah.
None of them permitted.
Figure or body, I thought it was quite good, didn't you?
Did you?
Yeah.
I didn't think it was bad. I said face and body.
Face and body. All right, that gets a match. You said the magic word body.
Crown.
A better crown. The princess said to the prince, you had a better crown when you were a frog.
I went another way.
All right. What do you say to this, Marjorie?
I like your body.
Your body. Vote for Sharon.
I did a little editing for television. I said head.
Head. All right. What do you say, Edie?
Well, I thought about it and I thought about it.
Yes.
And then I just thought about the lips and kiss.
You had a better kiss when you were a frog. You did indeed kiss a frog, didn't she? All right. Here we go, Kathy.
Great job.
Sidney is the world's worst scientist. Yesterday, he came up with a method for turning gold into blank.
Say that again.
Sidney is the world's worst scientist. Yesterday, he came up with a method for turning gold into blank. Here we go, Kathy. Sidney is the world's worst scientist. Yesterday, he came up with a method for turning gold into blank.
Copper.
Copper. Well, copper is less expensive than gold, but there are some even more base metals than that, Bernie, right?
Well, Gene, the classic joke that is evoked by this entire question is not permitted to be discussed on television. So I came up with lead.
Lead. You're talking about turning gold into caca? Oh, you can't say that. Okay.
No, Drake. You see, he's a really terrible... You said terrible, right? No! He devised a method to turning gold into Confederate money.
Uh-huh.
I thought it was going to get a better...
Yeah, it gets a murmur. Yes, that. Sir. Okay. I understand.
Ten.
All right. Now, here we go with Marjorie. What
I'm
have you got?
I'm too subtle for this
the
room.
The definitive answer, gold dust.
Gold dust. Uh-huh. Scoey?
She said it was definitive.
It was good. Right. Edie, what do you got for us?
But it's the old lead out.
The lead out. Yeah, get the lead out. 3-0 the score. In Sharon's favor, that's round one. Now this for you. 10 seconds to say goodbye.
Take
goodbye.
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 Bye.
Say goodbye. Bye. Say goodbye, everybody. Gene Rayburn, join us next time. Goodbye.
Today's contestants will also receive a beautiful jewelry ensemble in the Golden Manor of Monet, designed and crafted by Monet, the master jeweler. And beautiful wall covering and easy-to-use squares. Dip them in water and put them up. DuPont Flair squares make decorating easy. And Baker's Secret from Echo, the silicone-coated nonstick bakeware, is the easy way to better baking. Makes clean-up easy as pie. And a tray, and why not switch to Listermint with its fresh, minty taste or zesty Listermint cinnamon. They taste as good as they work. And Bill Todman production. The program was edited for broadcast.